Okay, good morning, Bandal. Today's topic is a discussion on simple digital filters. Before going to that, let us have a look into these ones. Suppose if I consider an LTI system, linear time invariant system, with the simple response h of n, and x of n is my input, then what is the concerned output? Just a linear convolution, right? This is a linear convolution of those two sequences. If I apply DTFT both sides, then what's happening is, this is h of e over j omega, this is h of e over j omega, which corresponds to frequency response of the system. This is frequency response of the system, right? Then y of e over j omega is multiplication. When there are convolution in time domain, multiplication in frequency domain, h of e over j omega into x of e over j omega. And when coming to z transform domain, this is known as transfer function. Transfer function, y of z equals to h of z into x of z. It means h of z equals to y of z by x of z, or h of e over j omega equals to y of e power j omega by x of e power j omega. When they are existing, when DTFT exists, we can do this one. If it won't exist, we can't do anything, right? When z transform exists, then you can do such things. That means some RVC is there, right? For example, Rx represents RVC for this one, x object. Rh represents RVC for h object. Then the RVC for y object will be at least this much. That will contain Rx intersection with Rh. At least this much will be there as part of your RVC for y object. Based on the properties, we can say this. And one more thing is, let's try to recap once again about causal system. What is the condition for causal system? In terms of months. Yeah. It happened.
T is equal to 0 for n less than 0.
This should be a condition for causal system. And for the stable system, for the stable system, h of n should be absolutely summable, like sigma n equals to minus infinity to plus infinity. This impulse response should be absolutely summable. This should be finite, right? This absolute summation. Then you can say this is a stable system. Yeah, what is this in terms of z transform? For this, what should be that one? That should be right-sided sequence, right? We have seen that when h of z equal to p of z by q of z, ratio of polynomials, that should satisfy this condition, right? That should be right side of rightmost pole, right? That should be like this one. If you are obviously like that, that's causal. For stability, mod z equal to 1 should be null. Yeah. For stability. When there is ratio of two polynomials, that h of z, then you need to satisfy this condition. And RVC should be right side of rightmost pole. Outside of outmost pole, not right side. Oh, can someone define, yeah, before discussing about filters, you might heard about 3 dB cutoff frequency. Or half power. Yes, what is the meaning of this one? Let me try to take this expression. My input, the DTFT is frequency domain, h of e power j omega. This is my frequency response. This is the output I am going to get in terms of frequency domain expressions. What I have is, for my LTI system, it's a gain at a frequency of omega. Gain at frequency omega. I want to bother about power gain. This can be written like this. I'm just taking modulus, after that doing square both sides. It's known as power gain. This is known as an amplitude gain. If I take magnitude both sides, mod A equals mod A into mod B, right? And I'm doing the same thing. This corresponds to amplitude gain. This corresponds to power gain. Half power cutoff frequency means? Half power means, what is the meaning of that? Or half power cutoff frequency corresponds to, at that frequency, this should be satisfied. Then, according to this, I am going to get mod y of e power j omega whole square equals to 1 by 2 into mod x of e power j omega whole square. Here, my power gain is 1 by 2, right? That's why I am calling it like half power cutoff frequency. The concerned cutoff frequency omega c is known as half power cutoff frequency or 3 dB cutoff frequency. 3 dB cutoff frequency means 10 log power gain. If I consider 10 log base 10, this power gain 1 by 2, then I am going to get minus 3 dB. This is minus 3 dB. That's why we are calling it as 3 dB cutoff frequency. Gain 1 means 10 log 1. Log 1 is 0, right? At gain 1, we are going to have 0 dB. Gain 1 means highest possible gain is 1, right? Suppose if I consider some ideal low pass filter with a cutoff frequency of omega c, for example. Then, that is the ideal low pass filter, the gain in pass band should be 1, right? The gain in the stop band should be 0. Highest possible gain in the pass band is always 1, even if you consider practical filters. That's what we are preferring, right? When coming to passive filters. If you go for active filters, you might expect more than 1 gain due to that amplification factor. Otherwise, highest possible gain is 1, right? It means for the highest possible gain, 10 log 1 equal to 0 dB. 0 dB the highest possible gain. 3 dB below that highest gain. Highest possible gain is 0 dB, right? And we are considering just 3 dB below that. That is known as minus 3 dB gain. 3 dB gain, or you can say this power gain is minus 3 dB, which is also known as half power gain. Then in terms of amplitude, what is half power gain means? Mod h of e power j omega c should be equal to how much? Yeah, what should be this then? 1 by root 2, right? I'm taking square root both sides. Mod h of e power j omega c should be equal to 1 by root 2. This is known as, if you satisfy this condition, that is known as 3 dB cutoff frequency. This omega c is known as 3 dB cutoff frequency or half power cutoff frequency. When coming to power, we are doing square, right? That should be 1 by 2. Here, amplitude means 1 by root 2, right? This one. That's the difference. When coming to dB scale, that should be minus 3 dB. Yeah, these are just terminologies. Simple first order FIR low pass filter. Yeah, we are trying to call this as simple FIR low pass filter. Can you just tell me why this is FIR low pass filter? Okay, can someone tell me if this is my input sequence and this is my transfer function, and what is the output I am going to get? Y of n equals to how much?
1 by 2 delta of n plus?
No, h of n, you are commenting about h of n, right? 1 by 2 delta of n plus 1 by 2 delta of n minus 1. Directly z power minus 1 means delay by 1 sample. Z power minus k means delayed by k samples. Like that you can think. 1 means straight away you can write that one. It means we are going to get as follows. 1 means simply x of n I am going to get. Otherwise you can do convolution, there is no issue with that. We are going to end up with same thing, right? Z power minus 1 means delay by one sample. Divided by 2. This what I am going to get. My claim is this acts like a low pass filter. This acts like a low pass filter. And our target is we need to find the 3 dB cutoff frequency for this one. 3 dB cutoff frequency for this. Okay, let me start with h of z equals 1 by z power minus 1 by 2. Then what is my frequency response? Replacing z with e power j omega, right? This is my frequency response. Now I want to find mod h of e power j omega. If this is equal to 1 by root 2, then the concerned frequency corresponds to 3 dB cutoff frequency. That's what my claim. I have given you some shortcut for this, right? To take this part common, then e power j omega by 2 plus e power minus j omega divided by 2. Right. Then what is this? What is this thing?
Cos omega by 2.
Cos omega by 2, right? And magnitude I am questioning for this. Mod AB equals to mod A into mod B. Magnitude of this one is 1 always. And mod cos omega by 2, right? This is my transfer function. This is my frequency response of the system. Now, if I want to find 3 dB cutoff frequency, I have to check for, this is the 3 dB cutoff frequency. Yeah, what is the 3 dB cutoff frequency here? This should be equal to 1 by root 2. E power j omega c should be equal to 1 by root 2. Yeah, at what point this will happen?
90?
Yes, 90, right? For omega c equals to pi by 2 radians, we'll think about in radians instead of degrees all the time. Because omega from 0 to pi, right? Pi is the highest possible digital frequency. 0 is the lowest possible digital frequency. We'll bother about positive frequencies only. We are not worried about negative side. There's just a symmetry. Mathematical symmetry, that's it. It's the lowest possible frequency, it's the highest possible digital frequency. That's why think about always in radians instead of degrees. Omega c equals to pi by 2. At pi by 2 cos pi by 4, which is equal to 1 by root 2, right? And let me try to plot these ones. If you try to plot this, then we are going to get this as follows. See, this is actually 3.14, this last point, roughly 3.14. is somewhere is known as pi, right? Pi radians. This is 0, this is pi. This point is pi. 3.14 something is there. This is irrational number. And pi by 2 somewhere. Yeah, where is pi by 2? 3.14 by 2, roughly somewhere around 1.5 plus something. Somewhere around here. At this point, you can see the gain is around 0.7. 1 by root 2 means root 2 by 2. Root 2 means 1.414 roughly. 1.414 divided by 2 means 0.7.
0.7.
Somewhere here we are getting 3 dB cutoff frequency. And you can see, up to this point, if you consider up to this point, the gain is above 0.7. So you can call it as pass band. It's a practical filter. This is not an ideal filter. And after this point, the gain is less than 0.7. Just for the sake of simplicity, let me call it like stop band. There is some transition band also. Let me call it as stop band. This whole thing. It means this is acting like a low pass filter with a cutoff frequency, 3 dB cutoff frequency of pi by 2 radians. Omega c equals to pi by 2 here. It's like a low pass filter, right? A low frequency is high gain. High frequency is low gain. It's a low pass filter. And similarly, let me consider basic FIR high pass filter, FIR, finite impulse response. Because if you look into h of n, it's just delta of n minus delta of n minus 1 by 2. Length of that one is just 2, right? That's why I'm calling it as FIR, finite impulse response filter. It's a high pass filter. when this is my transfer function, if the input is x of n, then I am going to get output as 1 by 2 into x of n minus x of n minus 1. That's it. That's what we are seeing here, right? Z power minus 1 means delay by one sample, x of n minus 1. And if you do similar analysis here, then we are going to end up with this expression. Mod h of e power j omega equals to mod sine omega by 2. And we are going to claim that this is a simple high pass filter. If you try to sketch this one from 0 to pi, this is pi, 3.14 somewhere here. See my pi, the 0, omega from 0 to pi. And you can see this one, nearby high frequency components, you have high gain, this is a pass band. Nearby low frequency components is low gain, right? It's almost like a stop band. And 3 dB cutoff frequency, you got once again at pi by 2. Somewhere around here, you got 3 dB cutoff frequency, where the constant gain is 0.7 roughly, this one. And this is like a stop band, and this is like a pass band. It's some sort of high pass filter, right? A basic, simple high pass filter with a 3 dB cutoff frequency of pi by 2. Let me go for second order FIR band pass filter. Second order in the sense, we have at max two delays here, right? Z power minus 2 means delayed by 2 samples. First order means this one, only one delay, one sample delay. And when my input is x of n, the output I'm going to get is 1 by 2 into x of n minus x of n minus 2. Because z power minus 2 means delay by 2 samples. That's what we are having. This is my y of n. And if you do similar analysis here, replacing z with e power j omega here, z equal to e power j omega, then we are going to end up with this. And if you simplify in the similar manner, and if you found magnitude of that one, that is mod sine omega, mod sine omega, and if you try to plot this one, this is 0, omega equal to 0, this is omega equal to pi. Sine 0 is 0, sine pi also 0, sine pi by 2 is 1, right? We are going to get peak value at pi by 2. Peak value at pi by 2, right? Then what is my 3 dB cutoff frequency here? Yeah, what is the 3 dB cutoff frequency here? That should be equal to 1 by root 2. When this is equal to 1 by root 2?
45.
Pi by 4, right? At pi by 4 radians, 3.14 divided by 4. That is less than 1 and above 0.5, right? Somewhere here. 0.7, right? This gain should be 0.7. Pi by 4. At pi by 4. And that will repeat, right? It will repeat after pi by 2 once again. What is this point? This is 3 pi by 4, I think. Is it 3 pi by 4? At pi by 4 and at 3 pi by 4, we are going to get equal gain, that 0.7 gain, 1 by root 2. You can call this part as pass band, remaining part as stop band, just for the simplicity. That pi by 4 to 3 pi by 4 is your pass band and remaining part is your stop band. This is behaving like a band pass filter, right? Yeah, this is behaving more or less like a band pass filter. And this is a simple band stop filter. H of z equals to 1 by 2 into 1 plus z power minus 2. Then y of n equals to x of n by 2 plus x of n minus 2 by 2. This is delay by 2 samples, right? That's what we are having here. And if you replace z equal to e power j omega, then we are going to, the final simplified version is magnitude of theta equal to omega mod cos omega. Then what is the 3 dB cutoff frequency for this?
Pi by 4.
Once again, pi by 4 and 3 pi by 4, right? Yes, once again, pi by 4 and 3 pi by 4. Pi by 4 somewhere here, right? Let me consider 0.7. Yes, somewhere here. This is my pi by 4. And 3 pi by 4. These are my cutoff frequencies. Up to pi by 4, this is pass band. And after 3 pi by 4, that is pass band. In between, that is the stop band. Exactly at omega equal to pi by 2, cos pi by 2 is 0. It's known as notch frequency. Notch frequency. Sometimes this is termed as notch filter also. It is a right to remove that narrow band of frequencies, right? It's trying to give very low gain for this set of frequencies. The notch frequency pi by 2, omega goes pi by 2. It's like a band stop filter, right? Stopping the band of frequencies from pi by 4 to 3 pi by 4 effectively. Okay, let me look into simple first order IIR low pass filter, infinite impulse response filter. See, why this is known as IIR filter? I'll let you read this expression. FIR low pass filter, simple IIR low pass filter. The filter we consider is 1 plus resolution average operation, the backward difference, and followed by average, right? Some sort of moving average system. And IIR low pass system, H object equals to 1 minus alpha by 2 due to this fact, right? Okay, that's fine. See, as usual, 1 plus z power minus 1 by 2. In addition to that one, we have extra pole at alpha, 1 minus alpha z power minus 1. And highest gain should be equal to 1 according to our theory, right? According to our passive filters theory, the peak gain should be 1. In order to normalize that one, we are having this extra factor here into 1 minus alpha. So that this gets cancelled out at the peak gain, and you are going to get highest gain is 1. It's just a normalizing factor. No need to worry about that much. Yeah. See, 1 minus alpha by 2 into 1 by z power minus 1 divided by 1 minus alpha z power minus 1. We need to maintain this one for stability. Why? Mod alpha less than 1 should be maintained. Why? For stable and causal system. This is an IIR system, right? Do you agree that this is an IIR system? Okay, yeah, one question. Is it FIR system? H of n equals to delta of n plus delta of n minus 1 is 1 by 2, right? 1 by 2. You have the length of this one is just two samples, right? We have H of 0. Yeah, let me have that plot. And then you might get some intuition, right? For n equal to 0, this is 1 by 2. For n equal to 1, also this is 1 by 2. For others, this is always 0. And what is the length of this H of n? What is the length?
2.
2, right? Length is 2. 2 means less than infinity. Length is less than infinity. So we can call it as finite impulse response system. Here we are calling it as IIR system. The reason is, I can expand this, right? 1 minus alpha divided by 2. And I have 1 plus z power minus 1. And I have one more factor here. 1 minus alpha z power minus 1 whole power minus 1. This is that factor, right? 1 minus alpha z power minus 1 whole power minus 1. I took it to the numerator thing. That's it. What is the expansion for this? This part. 1 minus alpha z power minus 1, 1 plus, see, 1 minus x whole power minus 1 equals to 1 plus x square plus x cube plus and so on when mod x less than 1. Otherwise, you can't do this one. That's why we have mod alpha less than 1, right? For stability, stable and causal system. When mod alpha less than 1, we have pole at z equal to alpha. You can see this. If you equate this one to 0, we are going to get z equal to alpha. we have pole at z equal to alpha. For causal system, mod z should be outside of that pole, right? Mod z should be greater than mod alpha for a causal system. And for a stability, that mod z greater than mod alpha should include mod z equal to 1. That's possible only when this is true. In general, we want this one, right? Causal and stable system. Causal means practically implementable system. Stability we require, right? Here in place of x, we have alpha z power minus 1. This is alpha square z power minus 2 plus and so on. Now, if you try to multiply this one with this, then what we are going to get? 1 into this, same thing. Plus z power minus 1 into this one means this is z power minus 1, alpha z power minus 2 plus alpha square z power minus 3, alpha cube z power minus 4 and so on. And if you try to add them, that's going till infinite, right? Till index infinity. Infinite index, that n equal to infinity. The length of this one is infinity. So this is known as infinite impulse response system, IIR system. This one, due to this pole. Let us have a look into this filter response once. This is the frequency response of that system. This is our system. H of z equals to 1 minus, okay, let me discuss more about this. Can someone tell me what is y of n here? It's given to you, this thing, 1 minus alpha by 2 into 1 plus z power minus 1 divided by 1 minus pole at alpha, right? Yeah, this is given to you with mod alpha less than 1. So that this is causal and stable system. By default, yeah, ROC, by default, mod z greater than mod alpha we are considering. So that this is causal and stable. This is the ROC we are considering. This can be written like y of z by x of z, right? Now, yes. Can someone guide me? What is my y of n? See, in order to know about your y of n, you can cross multiply both sides. Let's do this cross multiplication and y of z into this one. Okay, let me redo this once again. Y of z into 1 minus alpha z power minus 1 equals to 1 minus alpha by 2 into 1 plus z power minus 1 into x object. Yes, now can someone tell me what is this inverse transform for this? Y of n minus alpha y of n minus 1 equals to 1 minus alpha by 2 into x of n plus x of n minus 1. This is my difference equation. From there, I can have my y of n equals to, if I take this side, that will become like plus, right? Like this, I am going to get. Right, take this right side of that one. Y of n equals to alpha into y of n minus 1 plus this one. Recursive expression. I am trying to implement this IR system, the alpha of regression. The past output, right? Present input and past output. This is my expression, this is my system, IR system. And if you try to replace z with e power j omega, and if you try to simplify this one, simplification means you need to do mod h of e power j omega c equals to 1 by root 2. After simplification, we are going to end up with this expression. This is our 3D big dot frequency. Cos inverse 2 alpha by 1 plus alpha square. Now if I change my alpha, this is also changed, right? Is it true or false? If I want to change my 3dB cut off frequency, this is the 3dB cut off frequency I got. If I try to change this alpha, this parameter alpha, this is the parameter alpha. If I try to change this parameter, my 3dB cut off frequency also will change, right? It's a tunable. You can try to tune this filter. Tunable filter. Tunable IR low pass filter. When coming to FIR low pass filter, is it tunable or not? Yeah, what about this? Can we compare with this? Is the 3dB cut off frequency fixed or variable here? Yeah, can you respond?
Fixed, sir.
Fixed to pi by 2, right? We can't tune this 3dB cut off frequency. But when coming to IAR filter, some benefit we are having, right? There might be some complexity due to that regression and everything. But we are having some benefit with that IAR system, right? We can try to tune this parameter alpha so that I can modify my 3dB cut off frequency for low pass filter. That's the benefit I'm going to get with this extra complexity. It's a tunable low pass filter. Basic, simple first order IAR low pass filter. These are just some examples. For alpha equal to 0.2, we need to maintain this, right? For stability and causality. Mod alpha less than 1. Mod alpha should be less than 1. That's why I can show some values like this. See, this figure is generated using MATLAB. This one. And if I substitute alpha equal to 0.2, the constant omega c, I am going to get 0.37, roughly 0.37 pi. You see my 3dB cut off frequency. It's a blue color, right? 3dB cut off frequency means 0.7, right? This is my 0.7 line. It's 0.7 roughly, that gain. This is my 3dB cut off frequency. 0.374 pi. Yeah, I forgot to tell about this. For this x coordinate, we considered omega by pi, omega divided by pi. It means what is this value? What is this omega?
Pi.
Pi, right? Omega by pi equal to 1 implies omega equal to pi. This is 0.4 pi, 0.6 pi, 0.8 pi, 0.2 pi. This is 0 pi. That's it. 0 to pi means 0. That's it. Somewhere around 0.37, we got a gain of 0.7, right? Somewhere around here. And for alpha equal to 0.4, our passband gain shifted to 0.25 pi roughly. Somewhere here, right? And for alpha equal to 0.8, roughly 0.07 pi. This is my passband. That means my practical low pass filter cutoff frequency keeps on decreasing as I am increasing my alpha value, right? That thing you can observe here. We have three different low pass filters, practical low pass filters with different cutoff frequencies. So tunable due to this parameter alpha. Alpha is the tunable parameter. Similar manner, we can have simple first order IAR high pass filter. This is also IAR system, right? Yeah, you can have a look into this. This is 1 plus alpha by 2. Just normalization factor so that you can try to make the peak gain to be 1. Highest gain in this. That's 1, right? Somewhere here. This is similar to your earlier FIR system only. 1 minus z power minus 1 divided by 2. And we have pole at alpha, z equal to alpha, divided by 1 minus alpha, z power minus 1 into this one, 1 plus alpha by 2. We have extra pole at alpha as compared to your FIR high pass system. It's a only difference. And even if you try to simplify this also, do z equal to e power j omega, and after that equate mod h of e power j omega equals to 1 by root 2, then we are going to end up with omega c equals to this much. It's exactly same as your previous one. There's no difference. Cos inverse 2 alpha by 1 plus alpha square only once again. But this time that is high pass. Earlier that is low pass system. If I try to plot this, magnitude spectrum. Then I am going to get like this. This is also omega by pi once again. It means this is pi. 0.4 pi, 0.2 pi like this. Then alpha equal to 0.2, 0.37 pi is that 3 dB gate of frequency. At 0.7 gain, right? This is blue colored one. Somewhere here I got 3 dB gate of frequency. This is high pass system, right? Up to this stop band, above this pass band. And similarly for alpha equal to 0.4, my 3 dB cutoff frequency decreases, right? It's 0.7. This is my 3 dB cutoff frequency somewhere here. This is stop band, this is pass band. And alpha equal to 0.8, this is my 3 dB cutoff frequency. This one, this is my 3 dB cutoff frequency. And this is pass band, this stop band. Here high pass systems. Here also mod alpha less than 1 for stability and causality. Let's merge both of them. Simple first order IIR low pass filter and IIR high pass filter. As we already saw, the 3 dB cutoff frequency is same for both of them, right? As inverse 2 alpha by 1 plus alpha square for both of them. That's why they will intersect at 0.7. It's 0.7, right? At 0.7, those filters will intersect because both of them are having the same 3 dB cutoff frequency, right? They'll intersect. If you want, you can have a look into this. For alpha equal to 0.2, this one is my high pass system. This one is my, this red colored one. This is my low pass system. Both are intersecting at 0.7 gain. And this is my 3 dB cutoff frequency for both of them. That's equal for both. Similarly for 0.4 and alpha equals to 0.8. It's some sort of complementary, right? Are you looking like that? Just look into this red colored one. Forget about the others. Whenever you have high gain, here you are getting low gain. Whenever you got high gain for this one, you are getting low gain for this second system. Similarly here also for blue colored one, high gain for this, low gain for this. High gain for this, low gain for this. Opposite, right? Some sort of complementary nature is there, right? Yeah, these kind of effects we are going to use for earphones, that dual channel earphones. Multi-channel means, see, for example, okay, have you observed this? Like when you try to listen to some songs, left earphones, you'll try to listen some sounds. Right earphone, you'll try to listen to some other sounds. Have you observed that one? Okay, have you ever used earphones to listen to songs? Yeah, you should respond, right? Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Okay, have you observed like left earphone, you are listening something, right earphone, you are trying to listen something else at the same time?
Yes, sir. It's true.
There, right? See, such kind of effects can be created with the help of these filters. It's possible. For example, for left earphone, you can apply this high pass filter, blue color. For right one, you can apply this low pass filter. Similarly, you can do for left earphone, this red color one. For right earphone, you can apply this red colored low pass system. They're more or less complementary, right? For low frequencies, one earphone, that gain is high. That means you might listen to that speech signal bit louder as compared to high frequency music signals. That opposite effect you can see in other earphone, right? Such effects you can create. It's possible. And simple second order IIR band pass filter. This is H object. It's a transfer function for that one. It's a IIR system. Yeah, no need to worry about the computations. Finally, we are going to end up with this one. Beta equals to cos omega naught. And bandwidth equals to cos inverse 2 alpha by 1 plus alpha square. See, bandwidth is defined as follows. Bandwidth of this band pass filter is See, for the band pass filter, you'll have 2-3 dB cutoff frequencies, right? 2-3 dB cutoff frequencies. For example, let me consider this blue colored one, 0.7, right? This is 1-3 dB cutoff frequency, and this is another 3 dB cutoff frequency. This is the pass band, this part. This is my pass band, and remaining is stop band. That pass bandwidth corresponds to my bandwidth. The gap between the two 3 dB cutoff frequencies, that's my bandwidth, which is nothing but cos inverse 2 alpha by 1 plus alpha square. It's exactly same as this one, right? There's no change till now. The same as that. And the center frequency omega naught. This is my center frequency omega naught. The peak gain 1. I'm getting at omega naught. At this is my center frequency omega naught. That will satisfy this condition. Beta equals to cos omega naught. This example where beta equals to 1 by 2. I fixed my beta to 1 by 2 and I tried to change my alpha. Then what's happening to this filter? These are bandpass filters only, these three. Bandwidth is changing, right? You can see, when I fix my beta, center frequency is fixed. Only bandwidth is getting modified because bandwidth is a function of alpha, right? I'm changing alpha. So my bandwidth also changing, right? Here that is decreasing. If I increase my alpha, this is decreasing. It means my bandwidth is decreasing. Earlier, this is my bandwidth, this much. For second case, this much is my bandwidth, around 0.7. And for third case, this is my bandwidth. That bandwidth got decreased, right? As my increase, as I change my alpha. Similarly, if I want to change my center frequency, I can change with the help of this parameter beta. I can tune this parameter beta. If you want to change my bandwidth, I can tune this alpha. If you want to change my center frequency, I can tune this beta. That's what I'm going to do here. I'll fix my bandwidth here. For example, alpha equal to 0.4 implies bandwidth equal to roughly 0.265. You can see at 0.7, this to this gap is same as this gap, and that gap is same as this point to this point. The three pass band bandwidths are same, right? But only center frequency got modified due to change of beta. Here I am trying to modify my beta. I want to tune my parameter beta. I'm just replacing first beta corresponds to cos pi by 3, and second beta, this one corresponds to cos pi by 2, and third one corresponds to beta equals to cos 3 pi by 4. By tuning this parameter beta, I can change my center frequency. By tuning this alpha, I can change my bandwidth. I can tune any one of them, or I can tune both. I can tune both at a time. That's also fine. Because they are behaving independently, right? And this is my IAR band stop filter. Yeah, I can have a look into this one. The similar behavior you can see. Just like your bandpass system. Yeah, you can analyze this one. There's no issue with this. Similar analysis like your bandpass.